How's the weather around here? The thing that brings everyone together, I guess, is Cardinals baseball.
Growing up in St. Louis, watching the Cardinals with my grandma, and you know, her passion for baseball transferred down to me. We live baseball.
Right, so when I was growing up, you got to go to the Cardinals game, like you marked that on your calendar, you circled it. It's all everyone talks about, barbecues. You know, you're going there, hey, what about this? And they're talking about trades and free agents. Like, it's crazy. Like, my mom knows everything that's going on with the Cardinals. It's just the way it's been, and I think it's been like that for a really long time.
Rawlings Sports, a St. Louis ball glove maker since 1887, is launching a new kind of glove.
I mean, it truly is like nothing else we've ever made.
With a history unlike any sport, baseball perpetually lives in two worlds. On one hand, tradition.
You're dealing with a very traditional sport, and inside of that traditional sport, a ball glove is, you know, the most traditional.
On the other, revolution. But Rawlings has made their living by revolutionizing the sport. The first baseball glove appeared in 1875 when St. Louis Brown Stockings' Charles Waite slipped on a pair of dress gloves with the fingers cut off so he could grip and throw. Despite being ridiculed, he set the trend in motion. Since then, Rawlings emerged as the leader of defensive innovation, changing the way the game is played along the way. In 1920, with insight from Cardinals spitballer Spittin' Bill Doak, Rawlings introduced the first glove with a web between the thumb and pointer finger. It was such an improvement for fielders that it quickly became the most popular glove ever sold. As the top glove in pro baseball throughout the 20th century, Rawlings ball glove designers like Harry and Raleigh Latina and Bob Clevenhagen gleaned insights from legends like Mantle, Musial, Griffey, and Jeter. Sometimes these pro-inspired gloves were so good that they made them illegal. And now, Rawlings will break the mold again. In September 2018, platinum glover Francisco Lindor came to Rawlings ball glove designer Robert Newman with a problem.
You know, he was really the first one who came to us. He didn't want his glove changing in feel over time.
The properties of natural materials like leather, felt, and wool would not meet Lindor's standards. So the team at Rawlings had to do better.
So that's really what spun us off into 3D manufacturing and lattice designs.
Pushing the boundaries on glove technology, looking at new materials to lighten the glove.
We always get feedback from players and we always adapt.
Initially, it was, you know, try to make it as out there as possible.
So really just trying to look at every component that goes into the glove and how we can improve and make them optimized.
And we leaned pretty heavily on Lindor. You know, he was really the first one who came to us and said, you know, the traditional felt and wool is, it gets the job done, but I really wish there was something that was stiffer and stayed stiffer over time and stayed truer over time. He didn't want his glove changing in feel over time. And so that kind of really hit us hard, and we were like, okay, we need to address this.
Team Rawlings honed in on improving the parts of the glove that affect stiffness most, the thumb and pinky inserts.
We started just looking at what materials were out there, what could we explore, what could potentially work in a ball glove. So obviously they had to be durable, they had to withstand fatigue, repeated impact loading, so it's hard to find material that's lightweight that can also serve that function as well.
Rawlings called on Carbon, a pioneering 3D manufacturing company out of California, to create thumb and pinky inserts that were just right.
Once we established, you know, kind of that weight to strength ratio of the carbon pieces, And then we kind of started building around that.
The team then shifted their focus to creating durable outer parts that would break in but not break down. They added an adaptive conforming wristband, a laceless web top, a laceless palm, classic Rawlings heart of the hide leather for wherever the ball touches, and of course that show-stopping design that got everybody in baseball talking. Rawlings dubbed the new creation the REV1X.
We were calling the glove Prototype X for a long time, and we're like, this thing is so revolutionary, and we've been calling it Prototype X, and then REV1X just all kind of came together like that.
So when I gave Lindor his glove, he opened it up, and he's like, is this mine? And I said, yeah, this is yours. He goes, are you kidding me? I could take this to the field right now. He's like, I'm using this today.
Obviously, Lindor has a bunch of gloves, and he got his first shipment of gloves for him. He was using that glove the next day in spring training. So that never happens.
Lindor loved the results so much that he's been mixing and matching REV1X gloves based on the day of the week.
And you're relying less on a natural material, so you're going to be more consistent from glove to glove. Once he's got the glove broken in the way he likes it, he can, you know, go from one to another, and they're almost interchangeable at that point.
Toronto's Beau Bichette is on board too. And now Rawlings will be launching the REV1X to the public. We spoke with a young player that had been testing the glove the last two seasons now in the St. Louis area leagues.
What I really like about this glove is like the lightweight that it carries, and I really like the 3D looks that cover the glove. It makes it look like a cool like 3D printed glove. It's very unique the way it is, and that's mainly what I really like about it.
I also gave it a whirl, and I can say that it's the first glove I ever felt like I could put into a game on the first day I touched it. My teammate Stephen Flynn, who used it at short, is impressed by how light yet sturdy it is, and he loved the adaptive wristband and the overall look too. At launch, you'll see four colorways, with two more on the way in October. Each will retail at $400.
Got a 12 3/4 outfield camel H-web that will come in a lefty and a righty throw. We have a pitcher's model with our new REV1X two-piece solid web, 11 3/4. Also will come in left-handed throw. FL12, which is the optic eye web for your infielder, and then 11.5-inch eye web as well. So we've got the infield cover, we've got the pitcher's cover, we've got the outfield covered, lefties and righties. These will be available Rawlings.com, JustBallGloves.com, and DickSportingGoods.com on July 15th.